Hi, my name is M. Dhanashekaran and welcome to this Database Lessons video series. In this video, let us take a quick look at Oracle RDBMS architecture. You know, just to get us started for the SQL development. During the installation, Oracle software gets installed in one location, which is /app/sam/product. Then when we create a database, which is nothing but a bunch of files, they get created in another location, which is /app/sam/aradata. So when we start up an Oracle database, two things happen. First, an empty Oracle instance gets created in the memory. Then that instance opens the data files belonging to the database, and the database will be available for use. More like when you click notepad icon, it creates an empty notepad instance in the memory. Then we either open a text file or create one. When the Oracle database is open, to access it, you would need to log in as an user, meaning that we need to have database user accounts within the database. And when the users create tables, they create them in a logic structure called tablespace. A tablespace can be made up of one or more data files. So, from the OS perspective, we will see only the data files. But if we log into the database, then we can see the tablespaces. Objects such as tables are owned by users. For example, user 1 can create a table called test. It can be addressed as user1.test. User 3 can also create a table called test, and it can be addressed as user3.test. Also, if needed, it can be stored in the same tablespace. Note that they both are different tables. One is user1.test and the other one is user3.test. I named both the tables as test to explain the difference. Since user1 and user3 own an object, which is table in this case, they can also be called as schemas. User1 can be called as a schema and user3 can be called as a schema. User2 remains just as an user. A schema user can also be called as a owner for the objects it owns. Before giving example, please note that I changed the table names to avoid any confusion. Now, we can say user1 is the owner of the table customer and user3 is the owner of the table orders. If user1 has permissions to use the table space 2, then he or she can create a table there too and call it something else. In this case, the name of the new table is address. However, the user1 cannot name it as customer. Why? Because there is already a table called customer which belongs to that user. In other words, objects cannot have duplicate names within a schema or within a user. By default, owners have all the privileges on the objects they own. They can read, write, delete, modify the data. If needed, they can completely drop the objects. They can also grant access on their objects to others. For example, if user 1 grants read privilege on the customer table to user 2, then user 2 can read data from that table. Also, there will be powerful users with DBA privileges. They can do almost anything in the database. They can read, write on any table, drop anyone's table, etc. These accounts will be only used by DBAs for database administration purpose. Thank you for watching this quick overview of an Oracle RDBMS.